Hey guys, if we add an insoluble lead salt to tartaric acid or its salt, the reaction will result in the formation of insoluble lead tartrate. This white powder has one interesting property. If you heat it in a test tube sealed with cotton wool to restrict air access, lead tartrate will decompose into lead monoxide, water, carbon monoxide, carbon elemental lead in the form of nanopowder that readily ignites upon exposure to air. As soon as the cotton wool is removed, you'll notice sparks and smoke. Now I'll pour reaction products out of the test tube. Against a black background, the sparks generated during the combustion of lead powder are clearly visible. If this experiment is demonstrated on a white background, then you can see the formation of yellow-orange smoke, which corresponds to the color of lead monoxide. Unburned lead quickly oxidizes in air, turning it into a yellow monoxide. The black powder here is carbon and unoxidized lead. Before this, you saw how lead oxidized in air, but now let's see what happens if I pour this powder into a flask filled with pure oxygen. Yes, in pure oxygen, as expected, the oxidation of lead occurs much more intensely. But how will this reaction proceed if I pour this powder into liquid oxygen? Now let's carry out this reaction in reverse. In a wide test tube sealed with cotton wool, I'll decompose lead tartrate by heating. After this, I'll remove the cotton wool and add liquid oxygen to the resulting pyrophoric lead. Now let's see if lead will burn in an atmosphere of chlorine in the same way as it burned in an oxygen atmosphere. In an atmosphere of chlorine, instead of the yellow-orange smoke of lead monoxide, white smoke of lead dichloride is formed. For comparison with liquid oxygen, here is the reaction with liquid chlorine. And here I tried to pour pyrophoric lead into heated iodine. It didn't turn out very impressive, the first attempt didn't manage to get the petri dish with heated iodine. And here I pour lead powder into a cylinder with fuming nitric acid, with the vapors of which it also actively reacts. So guys, if you found this video interesting, then write your impressions in the comments. Perhaps I'll do another series of experiments with pyrophoric nickel and cobalt. I'd also like to thank my patrons, thanks to whom new videos are published on this channel. If you have the opportunity to join them, see the link in the description. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.